Hello people, in this video we want to look at the maternal complications due to multiple pregnancy, that is she's carrying twins or triplets or something. So what can be the complications for the mother? So she may have increased nausea, vomiting, that is hyperemesis, right? So it is possible that she'll have more nausea and vomiting, okay? She can have more chances of abortion. She can have anemia. Why anemia? Is she having any blood loss? Basically, the twins will have more iron and folic acid demand. Okay, so this when the folic acid is pulled away from the mother, she can develop anemia. Okay, so basically, iron and folic acid demand is more. Okay, because of 2-2 fetus, then there can be more chance of preeclampsia, pregnancy-induced hypertension, preeclampsia, okay, because of superabundance of chorionic villi. She can have more chance of diabetes mellitus. She can have polyhydramnios or oligohydramnios. Oligo is less amniotic fluid. Poly is more amniotic fluid. What exactly is happening? Why? So they are saying that this is more common in monozygotic twins. It involves the second sac. There is increased renal perfusion with consequent increased urinary output, right? So urine output of the fetus only will cause this amniotic fluid, will create this amniotic fluid, or it will add to the amniotic fluid. There can be malpresentation. So obviously there are two people inside. Can you expect both of them to be perfectly presenting, right? So look at this. In this, both of them are kind of seen in breech, but it can happen that one is cephalic presentation, the other is a breech presentation, right? So it can happen that there is more malpresentation. So it will be a complicated labor. That's why they are saying this is a maternal complication, right, of multiple pregnancy. Then let's check this. What the textbook says is the first one usually will be a vertex presentation and the second one would be a malpresentation. They didn't exactly say breech, it could be any other, but basically the second one would be a malpresentation. Okay, but what they're saying is these two babies can actually be quite small and this malpresentation may not be that big an issue if the two babies are small. Okay, now coming to what else here, antepartum hemorrhage. You can have more bleeding, more incidence of bleeding even before the delivery, even before her labor. So that is antepartum hemorrhage. So what happens in these people is that there could be two placentas, so the chance of placenta previa is more. Okay, so if abruption of placenta, it could be more. There could be cord entanglements. So everywhere we saw that there are two cords, right? There could be cord entanglement. So all these issues with placenta, etc., antepartum hemorrhage. So now let us go to other things, that maternal complications of multiple pregnancy. What are we looking at, guys? Are you focusing? We are looking at the maternal complications of multiple pregnancy. We have almost done with half. Okay, so now let us come to mechanical distress. So palpitations, dyspnea, varicosities, hemorrhoids, all these can be more when compared to a singleton pregnancy. Okay, so she can be feeling more breathless. Breathlessness increases because the pressure of the uterus, growing uterus on the diaphragm. So here again we have written the same thing, placenta previa, abruption, cord entanglement, all this can lead to antepartum hemorrhage, isn't it? Where did we put that here? Now, she can have premature rupture of membranes. Let's explain this. Why do you think this will happen, guys? Okay, now coming to preterm labor, she can go into preterm labor following this premature rupture of membrane. So basically the mean gestational period is like 37 weeks, they are saying. Okay, so basically why does this preterm labor happen? Because of this over distension of the uterus, right? Hydramnios, so much of premature rupture of membranes, right? all these can lead to preterm labor. So the uterus is distended, over distended, so you can understand that. Prolonged labor, she can be in prolonged labor. How many babies she has to deliver? 1, 2. Okay, so if it is more than that, then how? Prolonged labor. So this is definitely a complication for the mother. But they are saying this is actually more like a theoretical concept. In practical, it doesn't happen. Okay? Because whenever they are pregnant for more number of times, the more pairs they are, the pregnancy, the duration will become less. Okay? So only a primary male may have a long labor. But the subsequent pregnancies will have a shorter labor. Okay? Then, operative interference can become more for these people. So you will have to probably have a vacuum, forceps delivery for these people. Okay. Does cesarean section also come under operative interference? Yes. Now postpartum hemorrhage, guys. Now she has delivered. So all this is over. Preterm rupture of membrane, preterm labor, prolonged labor over. Then you also brought it out with some forceps, vacuum, cesarean, whatever. Now, everything is, all this is over. Now, coming to postpartum hemorrhage. So this is a real problem. So, pay attention here. This is a maternal complication of multiple pregnancy, postpartum hemorrhage. So, understand here that this can be because of the atonia of the uterine muscle. Over-distension of the uterus has happened when she was pregnant. So, there can be atonia of the uterine muscle. So, it's not contracting after the delivery. So, what will happen? There can be postpartum hemorrhage. A longer time is taken for the bigger placenta. Placenta can be big. It will take time to separate. So, there is bigger surface area of the placenta. Right? The placenta could have implanted in the lower segment. Okay? Which is less retractile. So, all these things will lead to more postpartum hemorrhage. This is very important, guys. So, can you say the causes of postpartum hemorrhage? The uterus is atonic because it was so distended because of twin pregnancy, right? And the big placentas are there. It will take time for these to separate and come out, right? And there is bigger surface area of the placenta exposing more uterine sinus. Implantation of the placenta could be at the lower segment, which is less retractile. So all this will lead to what? PPH, that is postpartum hemorrhage. Postpartum hemorrhage can be more. It's a real problem in multiple pregnancy. In puerperium, there can be increased chances of subinvolution. What do you mean by subinvolution, guys? It is nothing but slowing the process of involution or shrinking of the uterus. Basically, the uterus is taking so much time to go back to its normal state, kind of a thing, right? And then there can be infection because of all these obstetric operative interference that you did with the vacuum and the forceps and so many things. Because of all that, there can be more chance of infection. Due to operative interference, then she can have PPH, so there could be more blood loss, or there can be anemia, right? Lactational failure can happen. You have to assure her, okay? That's it, guys. So these are the maternal complications of multiple pregnancy. So you saw that from the beginning. Let's start. Nausea, vomiting, hyperemesis, abortion chances are more. Anemia can happen because of iron folic demand. Preeclampsia, PIH, diabetes mellitus, polyhydramnios, oligohydramnios, considering that there is renal perfusion is more. So there is increased urinary output by these fetus. Malpresentation, you can expect the first one to be a vertex and the second one to be a malpresentation, etc. Antepartum hemorrhage because of placenta previa or abruption or cord entanglement, can that lead to hemorrhage? I'm not sure. We'll not put this here. Okay, we'll put this somewhere here. So there can be mechanical distress because of, there can be dyspnea, palpitations for the mother. There can be cord entanglement. I think this is more like a fetal complication. What do you say? Premature rupture of membranes. Preterm labor, like because of this uterine distension. Average, they will usually be 37 weeks. Prolonged labor can happen. Okay, but this is more like a theoretical concept, they told you. Operative interference will be more. postpartum hemorrhage is very important because the uterus would have over distended, right? It will not come back soon. And the placentas are so huge, they won't separate. There could be a placenta previa. All these can lead to postpartum hemorrhage. Then, coming to puerperium, again, subinvolution may occur. Infection due to operative interference can happen, etc. Okay. Guys, in the next video, we will look at the fetal complications of multiple pregnancy. Okay. So far, what have we looked at? We looked at multiple pregnancies, the Helen's rule. We looked at the types of twins. We looked at why twins happen, right? What are the causes? Then we looked at now in the maternal complications of multiple pregnancy. We have looked at. Next, we will look at the fetal complications of multiple pregnancy. Okay. Bye-bye.